Hey folks, what's up? I'm not wearing tie-dye, that's what's up. Well, Father's Day is coming up, that's why. And look what I designed today. It is a necktie that you can actually wear, or Dad can wear it. And so I want to show you how to fold it. Want to learn? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this tutorial, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of kami. But if you want to make a necktie that would be a good fit for an adult, then I'd recommend using an 18-inch or 20-inch square. And if you want it to be striped, then you should use a paper that is colored on one side and white on the other. If you want a necktie that's the same color all around, then you should use a paper that's the same color on both sides. Let's make a striped necktie, so I'm going to use a sheet of kami, and let's begin coloring side up, and let's fold this corner up. How far? About this far. If you wanted a wider necktie, then you would fold it a little bit further down. But this is a good amount. Just try to do the same thing that I'm doing. It doesn't need to be perfect, though. All right, let's turn over right to left, and let's fold this edge up. How far? Well, you want the length of this segment to be equal to the length of this. So just estimate it and make the fold and flatten it. Okay, now let's fold this edge up on this edge. So we're just basically rolling it up like that. And let's do it again. Let's fold this edge up on this edge. And let's rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this flap up. Okay, now let's mountain fold in half. So we're just folding it in half. Like this. Okay, and unfold. And now we're going to make a second crease that's above this first one. And the position of the second crease is about like this. What we're aiming for is we want this rectangle to be 2 by 3. So just make sure that this length is a little bit less than this length. Like that. So here is crease number 1, here's crease number 2, and let's make a third crease that's above this one. So this should be the same distance as this. Okay? And let's fold it. So here we have crease number 1, crease number 2, and crease number 3. And so now let's make the second crease, and let's fold it down to the first crease. So we pinch it and fold it down so that it touches the first crease, and flatten it. So we just made a new fold in between. And now let's fold this flap behind on this crease. Okay? And let's turn over right to left. And now let's fold this flap back up. And we want the fold to align with this fold. So it is like this. Okay. Now let's rotate and zoom in. Now let's fold this edge up, and we're going to squash on this corner. So we're folding this edge up, and we want this width to be equal to this width. And we fold it up and squash. I'm going to zoom in so that you can see what's going on there. Again, we're folding up and squash. And let's rotate 180 degrees. Let's do the same thing on this side. So we're folding this edge up. We're folding this edge up to here. And squash right here. And now we're going to fold this edge to this edge right here. So just begin to fold like that. And now fold this whole corner up like this and squash. So what's happening is we're folding this edge up and then continuing this fold like that. And this fold will taper down to the corner. So it's like this. Okay. And let's rotate and let's do the same thing on this side. So we're going to fold this edge to this edge. And let's fold up like this. And squash it. And make the fold end up right here. Or if you want a thinner necktie, you could bring these edges up a little bit more like that. You see from the other side, it's like that. But I think it's good to have it meet the corner. Okay, and if you can, it would be good to try to stick this flap into this pocket. That would just make it kind of lie flat. But it might not look as clean because that shouldn't theoretically be able to fit in that pocket. But it'll end up being flatter if you just kind of stuff it in there. So, there it is. And let's fold this flap down like this. And this flap goes into the shirt to secure the necktie. And then these two points go behind the collar. All right, so now I'm going to show you how to put it on to a shirt.
All right, time to put this thing on. Or if you have a smaller one, time to put that one on. So what you do is you take this narrow flap and you just insert it into the shirt and take these two corners and put them behind the collar. Easy as that. It's a lot easier than tying a real necktie. Well, this is a real necktie. It's a real origami necktie. And same thing if you have a smaller one. You can even stick one on top of the other. And yeah, the super double necktie. All right, well, I hope you guys were able to fold this, and I hope that you like wearing it, or hope your dad or special someone enjoys wearing it, maybe to work, who knows. And happy Father's Day. All right, see you later. Bye.